This is a combination of a RICO and sexual trafficking case. Basically, they're charging Sean P. Diddy Combs with having a criminal enterprise that involves sex trafficking, it involved forced labor, obstruction of justice, and a number of other what we call predicate crimes, underlying crimes that the enterprise was engaged in. And so it's a very serious indictment.
You still here, you're rocking with the best. Don't worry if I write rhymes, I write checks. Who's the boss? Dudes is lost. Don't think because I'm iced out, I'm a cool off.
Really, what led to the criminal indictment were the civil lawsuits. You know, there's an upwards of 10 civil lawsuits, all containing very consistent and similar allegations of rape, sexual abuse, sexual assault, drugging, use of narcotics, things like that. And when you have a systemic line of civil lawsuits, all alleging the same thing, it's going to get the attention of the federal authorities, which they did in this case. And I think that those civil lawsuits kind of led a roadmap to suggesting that, you know, there's some criminal activity going on. Then the feds got involved. And ultimately, once the homes were raided, all of those civil plaintiffs were interviewed, as well as others. You know, that's where it led us today with this indictment.
Hey, straight ahead, dog. Straight ahead.
The penalties that P. Diddy Combs is facing are severe. In the federal system, RICO cases, sexual trafficking cases, have penalties of upwards of a minimum of 5 to 10 years, up to life. And you can get for racketeering alone up to 20 years, as well as the predicate crimes, which are kind of the underlying crimes. So he could be looking at life sentence, and certainly anything less than that. But it's going to be severe in light of the extended conduct that this occurred from 2008 up until they say the time of the indictment. In terms of the lawyers and the judges, you know, he's got a good defense team, and they've been anticipating this. You know, this is not a surprise. They knew this was coming. They started working on his defense a while ago. And the judges in Manhattan are competent judges, very experienced. You know, this is brought by the Southern District of New York, which is a very powerful division of the federal prosecutors. And so it's in the form that it should be, and that many cases like this are. So I would anticipate a big fight. Ever since the Me Too movement, there has been a big push to go after people who are engaging in criminal activity in terms of sex, rape, things like that. Before, it wasn't under the microscope and it wasn't the subject as much of the federal authorities, but ever since the Me Too movement, there's been a big push. And the push is to show that no matter how famous you are, no matter how much money you have, if you commit these acts, the government is gonna come down hard on you.
You know what, Tito?
In a minute.